hand it off, and BJ Sunset from mid-pack leads, and Wig Party flying out from the far outside. Katie is skimming the pylons early. She gets away in the third spot. Glowing Report has come out racing in fourth, and Pans Kulats is fifth into the opening turn. All-American Coco is sixth in behind her, and BJ Sunset leads it. Wig Party settled second. Glowing Report gets the jump on Katie as Brennan will gun her early for the lead, and she's coming first up. Now second and challenging for the front, and just as she gets to the lead, Miller makes a move with Katie, who's now coming first up. Opening quarter in 27-2. Glowing Report has the front, but the heavy favorite Katie is working her way closer on the outside, and she's now second, challenging for and taking the lead well before the half-mile marker. BJ's Sunset back in third. Wig Party of Left Heart is racing in fourth. Pans Kulats is fifth. All-American Coco is following in sixth. Show Off trying to flush some cover to the outside, and Pans Kulats is tipped out first over from fifth. Further back in eighth is JK Matchmaker, the half in 55-2. Panipulator is racing in ninth, and at the back of the pack is Lady's Portrait, who trails the field, and Miller is tapping the brakes with Katie looking for a bit of a third quarter breather. Glowing Report is right on his helmet, jammed in the box there in second. Up on the outside, coming first over, Pans Kulats, who's under urging, and Pans Kulats right on the wheel of Katie. A great striking spot for All-American Coco, and Show Off with a helmet trip is third over, just four lengths from the lead. Three quarters in 125-1, and they come to the top of the stretch in the Breeders' Crown. Katie is put to the test here. Pans Kulats dead game. Glowing Report with nowhere to go. All-American Coco kicking off cover. Pans Kulats wearing down Katie. Pans Kulats with a short lead. Katie, All-American Coco, Show Off on the outside. Pans Kulats leads it at the line. Pans Kulats pulls off the upset.
What an absolutely incredible effort from this two-year-old daughter of the Panda Rosa, let alone on any given night grinding first up. But she beats the unbeaten Katie to boot, and that filly was digging in for all she was worth. A homebred from Bob Glazer's Peter Pan Stables, trainer Ben Wallace has brought this filly along slowly, winning the crown in just her 10th career start. This was Wallace's 13th crown starter. Remember last year, his Totally Western upset favorite All-American Native. And it's ironic that Wallace is hoping to beat Glazer's No Pan Intended in the three-year-old Colt Pace in race five.
Well, Wallace pays Giant Killer again. Third crown trophy for Dubé. Gallo Blue Chip back in tonight's sixth. Dubé paid 108.20 with Shore by Five right here in 99. Winning owner and breeder Bob Glazer was ecstatic.
Well, she's come a long way in a short period of time. Ben has done an incredible job with her. Gary Baker broke her and shipped her up to Ben. And here I am standing in the winner's circle. Like I said, I can't believe it.